tone. Gracious vibrations to everybody listening to right now. I wanted to share with you five other ways that you can meditate, because everybody has a confusion, or not everybody, but some people believe that meditation is always just a sit down practice. When meditation is more than just a sitting down practice, I'm going to explain to you, or I'm going to give you five other ways that you can practice meditation. All right. Here is number one. The first form or way you can meditate is through long walks, nature walks. Preferably you want to do nature walks because you get to get that fresh prana, meaning breath. So you get to get that fresh breath, that you get to get your breath back, your renewed breath back. So many times do we sit down and we don't even notice our posture when we're sitting down. We either slumped over, or we either leaning this way or leaning that way. And when we're sitting down, so many times that we're causing a constriction of breath inside of our bodies. And so what happens when we get out and walk into nature, for those of us who don't like to do like workouts or exercise or stretching, opening up and expanding the lungs, expanding the chest, breaking up the stem cells inside the body, when we don't do that type of a workout for our bodies, then it's best to go and walk and get your body loose, get your body open, get your body awakened. And also, you know, nature. So you want to go into nature with your walks, because this gives you a renewed sense of feeling alive, a renewed sense of breath, a renewed mind. And so nature gives us that new breath, and it makes us feel rejuvenated, when really you didn't do much exercise to feel rejuvenated. You just got out and walked, but nature was the biggest catalyst of that, giving you that fresh oxygen, that fresh prana. So if you're going to do meditation, if you want to practice a form of meditation, the first one would be nature walks, long nature walks. Number two, the second way that you can meditate is through sports. And I like to say, when I say sports, I like to make sure that I preface it by saying practicing sports, not sports when you're engaged in an actual game, but just one-on-one shooting the ball around in basketball, or one-on-one running some drills. If you're in football, just by yourself, alone time with just hitting, you know, if you're in tennis, hitting the ball against the racket, anything that you are into as far as sports goes, you can find a meditation practice within that. You know, I was shooting basketball the other day and I found myself, you know, in this deep zone, this flow where I got lost. And that's what happens with sports. When you're practicing sports, sports gives you a way to get lost, get outside of your mind, to get out of your thoughts, and you just engage in the activity, and your body and your mind becomes one, you know, because you have to move your body in the rhythm of the game and the sport. And so your focus more on that, and your attention and awareness is on that. So sports, I like to say practicing sports, is another way that you can practice meditation. That would be number two. The third way that you can practice meditation is another simple one, which is tea and silence. I like to do this early sunrise. When I get up, I make my tea and I'll sit quiet and I just sip my tea. I'm not actually sitting to meditate. I'm not actually sitting to just, you know, close my eyes and be in thought, or be in mind, be in body and be in spirit. But I'm actually just sitting down, being quiet, saying nothing, not texting, not checking my phone, not getting on the phone, looking at Facebook and social media, of that stuff. I'm just sipping my tea. I'm just having silent time with my tea. This is a way that you can meditate, because what happens, the tea, the warmness, the warmth from the tea, the herbal aromas from the tea induces the mind into a state of meditation anyway. And so you want to get used to finding different ways to meditating, because you don't have to always sit down with your eyes closed and be quiet and be still. But sipping tea can get you into a good state of meditation, you know, because of the herbal aroma from the teas and the honey and whatever you use, you know, to sweeten your tea. But just tea alone, you know, with no additive. So try that. And if that's something you like to get into, if meditation is something you like to practice, try sipping tea. Tea silence. Silence tea, or whatever you want to call it. But tea and being quiet. Tea and being still. Tea and being silent. Practice that art and you will find yourself in a state of self-awareness, and you will actually be in control, more control of your day, practicing meditation in that way, especially in the sunrise when you wake up. The fourth way I like to meditate, or give you the fourth way you can meditate, is through connection. Connection is another way of meditating. You don't have to find, you know, circles that work, or, you know, places that you actually don't fit into to get engaged with people. You can find your friend, call up a friend, call up somebody you love. But I like to think of this type of connection with people you really don't mind being close with, you don't mind being intimate with, because intimacy, and the way I see it, is not something, you know, sexual intercourse, but intimacy is me into mate. I'm into the mate that I am with. You know, like the Aussies say, hello, mate. You understand what I'm saying? I am with a mate, whether it be a male or a female. And this is nothing sexual. This is everything to do with the being that I am with. You know, just a fellow mate. You understand what I'm saying? And so you want to be intimate, intimate. You want to be into your mate. Get into your mate. Get into their mind. Get into their thoughts. Engage with them. Look into their eyes. Connect with them. You understand what I'm saying? This is another way of meditating, because once you start to engage in conversation, you are becoming intimate. You are becoming into your mate, and your mate is becoming into you, and you are becoming intimate. So it's okay to connect with another mate on this level, be it male or female. And this is nothing to do, again, with sexual activity and trying to seduce someone into some type of flirtatious sexual temptation. This has nothing to do with that, but it has everything to do with just you being and feeling alive again with a normal conversation. Because so many of the social media devices, phones that we use to get on social media, acts as a filter, and we lose connection. We lost connection to each other, and so we have to gain that back. And the way we gain that back is doing what we used to do: getting outside, being together, connecting with friends, going out with friends, connecting. Put the phones down when you're with someone and engage into the conversation, engage into the thoughts of what's going on, engage in listening, hear, and feel. So that way you two can really become intimate, connecting. You're becoming one. You understand? And that is the goal, to become one with the being that you're with, wherever you are or whoever you're with. It has no implication on who it has to be that you're with as far as connecting. But it does, I say that it should be somebody you don't mind being close with, somebody you don't mind connecting on that level with, you know, being deep with on that level, where you're open up and you're letting your guard down and you're entering into a flow. See, you'll only let your guard down with somebody you really know and you really truly are connecting with. And so you want to get connected with people so that you let that guard down, and you two are entering now into a state of awareness with each other. Not just self-awareness, but awareness with each other, knowing the feelings, knowing what to say in order to, you know, get someone to feel better about themselves, and what not to say to not harm the person you're with. And that's how you engage in connection. So that's another way of meditation, because you get lost in that connection. You get lost in translation, or you get lost in conversation, not translation. And you're getting lost because you two are connecting. You're connecting. You're connecting. You're getting into mate, intimate. You're getting into mate, okay? And the final one is going to be the final way of, that was the fourth way of meditating. The fifth way of meditating, and the last way, is I like to say ride out. Just ride out. Whether you are, you have a car and you can drive, you on a bus and you just want to ride, it's okay sometimes to not have a destination. To just get in your car and just go. Just drive as far as east, north, west, south you can go, and engage yourself. It doesn't matter where you're trying to go, but engage yourself. Whether you're driving or whether you're on a bus, you know, get some headphones on and just begin to feel the wheels, you know, pick up the road. Begin to feel, because once you're on that bus, or once you're in the car, or you might skateboard like me. I have a longboard. I like the longboard. And one of the beautiful things of longboarding for me is that I love feeling. It induces me into a state of meditation, because I love feeling the ground, you know, when I'm kicking my foot. I love feeling my feet land on the gravel. I love feeling my feet touch the earth, touch the road. I love feeling my feet touch the gravel, pushing myself along. There's something really connected there's something really powerful. There's something really truly spiritual about being in tune, like especially with skateboarding or skating. But longboarding, there's something truly spiritual about it, because I am engaged fully in my whole body, my mind, and in my thoughts. And when I'm longboarding, I'm feeling my feet pick up the gravel, past the gravel behind me. And then I am also feeling and hearing the wheels roll on the gravel. And so the sound from the wheels rolling on the gravel is also inducing me into a great state of meditation, where I am being silent, I am being one, I am being still within myself. Although I am moving on a skateboard, you can still be still and still be moving, but to be still is to be in meditation while you're on a skateboard or while you're driving. You can be still and riding on the bus or on a train, taking a long ride somewhere. You understand what I'm saying? Because it's called being still in oneself. And I am still in myself even while I'm skateboarding, longboarding on my longboard. I can feel the meditation come on. And because I am connecting with the earth, I'm connecting with the sound from the road. There's really something truly spiritual about longboarding for me that I can't explain to you unless you actually do it and you can feel it, you can hear it, you can sense what I'm talking about. So ride out, long drives, get on the train, get on the bus. If you like to fly and you like to fly far places, get on a plane. But sometimes it's just great, it's just good to not have a destination. Go somewhere without a destination in mind. Go somewhere without looking for an end place. Just get on the road, just drive, and listen. Listen for the wheels. Feel the wheels connect with the earth. Feel the wheels connect with the road. Feel the roads pick up and speak, you know, sounds and great vibrations unto your beingness when you're sitting there and you're just listening for just the wheels on the road. And you can hear the actual road speak. You understand what I'm saying? Not a language, but you can hear the road as it go by, and you can almost tune into every single rock on the pavement that the wheels are coasting by. It's just because you're listening. And when you're listening, you'll hear things you never thought you heard before because you never heard them before. And so when you listen, you begin to hear them. So those are my five ways, other ways of meditation that you can do. Just recap real quick. You know, long walks, preferably nature walks, sports, practicing alone time in sports, whether you play basketball, football, soccer, get on the field and just kick the ball around, shoot the ball around, throw the ball around, do whatever. That's the way sports. Number three is tea and silence, just some tea, herbal tea. The aromas from that will help. Number four is connection, finding someone that you don't mind being intimate with. And get with them and connect with them. Lose all devices and lose all responsibilities and just connect. And number five is definitely going to be ride out. So you want to ride out, get in the car, get in the bus, get on the train, get in the plane, get on a skateboard, get on your skates, get on your bike, and just ride. Feel and hear the road. Connect with the road. Okay? Those are my five ways of other ways of meditation. I am Obeng. I appreciate you being here. I love you. I love me. I love us. I am and atone.